Okay, kids, welcome back, welcome back. Oh boy. I was not aware that this was coming, so it's kind of a surprise. Platoon level combat from Flying Pig Games. And this is a review copy that I've been sent, so, you know, I'm obligated to do something about it, right? I haven't paid any hard dollars, although I did place some orders on the Flying Pig site just a few weeks ago for a couple of other bits and pieces. So let's get a shrink wrap out of the way and have a look at and see what's inside. Last time I looked at the Platoon Commander system was way back in the Tiny Battles game, and it may have actually, was it actually in one of their Yar magazines? I don't know, I forget now. But nevertheless, it was a very small, you know, not this size, but about that size, small map, few counters, and it felt very similar to, or cousin of, or related to World at War / Nations at War, but with a few twists here and there. And I quite liked it. And I also liked the topic that was being covered. Felt like we were getting a little exploratory into the history. So that system has since evolved significantly, as you can tell. There's some meaty stuff inside these boxes. And we're going to take a look inside in a sec. But, you know, the company, Flying Pig, has decided to reorient the system and focus on World War II. And I think at the Platoon level, which there are very few titles or systems that cover that that scale in particular, I think that's pretty interesting. So we're gonna see, at least have a look inside. I'm not 100% familiar with the game. It's been a while since I touched it. So bear with me when it comes to looking at the components and all the rest of it and telling you what things are, because, you know, half the time, as usual, I don't really know. So that's two-player game for ages 12 and up, no less. 252 color, full-color, 1-inch square die-cut counters. Looks like we've got two mounted maps in here, geomorphically oriented, which is nice to see. Some playing cards, some aids, and a full-color rulebook and scenario book. Kursk, tough thing to cover at the Platoon level. So let's see what we got in here, right? I'm curious to see. It is a big, I think this is a 2 or 3 inch deep box. It's designed, of course, by Mark Walker, designed by David K. Van Hoos. But Mark Walker was probably the developer and or had his hand in this in some way, shape, or form. We can be sure of that. So first up, we've got a bunch of D10 dice. We've got some cards. Let's open these and see what they are. I recall that these cards are going to be something along the lines, yeah, that's right, along the lines of giving you additional capabilities during the turn, during recovery. It's going to apply some DRMs and morale adjustments and fun stuff like that, perhaps impact the enemy as well. So there's some cards for gameplay that can be applied depending on what part of the game turn you're in. I'm going to pull the whole lot out of here, out of the box. Nice big deep sturdy box. Our rule book. It's pretty light going. I think we're gonna be able to crush this pretty quickly. Let's see. Not even 18 pages. So we've got, that includes scenarios, of which there are 12 by the looks of it. With full color maps to let you know what needs to go where. Oh, you know what? This is not the rules. This is gonna be scenarios. Nope. This is the whole shooting match. Holy cow, look at that. Okay, this is gonna be fun. So, yeah, this is gonna play out pretty similarly, I think, to, let me just check here. I want to check if there's one feature in here. Draw action cards, determine initiative, do the rally phase, fire phasing, movement phasing, close assault phase. Yeah, this is going to be I go, you go by the looks of it, which is where it will depart from the earlier iterations, or the step cousin, whatever you want to call it, of World of War and Nations at War, which are chip pull. So you're going to have focus markers that are going to allow you to have benefits based on the leaders that are available to you. It's got your standard stacking rules, 2 per hex. There's a opportunity fire capability, of course. You can load and unload your vehicles. You're going to have to manage line of sight, which is all pretty straightforward and well outlined. There are zones of control in this game, and I think that's just going to add a movement point, so it's going to affect your ability to assault. So you're going to make sure you've got enough movement points to assault, close assault, if you want to bring an infantry platoon into close assault tanks and things like that. Artillery, airstrikes, and scenarios. Wow, so 10 pages of pretty concise looking rules. I'll go on a limb here and say I'm impressed that Mark and Co. have been as concise as they are here. So nice artwork on the cover, very thematic. Term record chart, sequence of play here for you. Firepower and results. And here's the interesting thing, we'll get into this in a second with the counters. We'll have a look at the counters here in a second, and we'll talk about what all the different colors and the different numbers mean to a limited degree. But we'll get there. Let's have a look at these guys. Let's see what the artwork looks like. So, you know, these are nice, thick counters. They're all well formatted and centered. They look quite pretty, don't they? That's clearly a Panzer IV, right? You've got your infantry units, pioneers, a wide variety of vehicles, and on the back, you've got them in reduced mode. Okay. Then you've got your Soviet forces in a similar nature, and hopefully they'll be facing the right way when they go to battle. We've got infantry and guards infantry. Lots of T-34s. Russian imported Churchills at the top there, very cute. 152s, KV-1s, artillery, Rex, moved. What else we got? And information counters, so we can know who is dug in, who is moved, and disruption markers on the back. So you can see that there's a standard unit is disrupted, reduced, and then eliminated. Yeah, the rerolling capability with the focus counter is kind of cool. Allows you to reroll a result. So let's have a look. Let's put this over here out of the way, and let's open up these two maps and see what they look like. Now these are geomorphic, so that means we should have fun and games seeing which way they all come together. And at this scale, I think it's 150 or 250 meters a hex. I have to check the rules. Let me just pull it out real quick and see if it says. 2 to 5 vehicles, which makes sense, 150 meters. So that's a nice scale for platoon level stuff. So these are muted colors. They are not they are not excessively vibrant. I like the palette combinations go together well. And here's a second map here. I don't know if those towns are real or not, but they have a Russian theme, a look to them, sound to them, right? So there's that going on. Yeah, this is going to be a pretty big playing area. Now, let's put that down here. There's obviously a wide variety of terrain types, which we can look at probably on the back of this card that I had before. There we go, terrain. Not alphabetized, but there's that. And I believe there's only one of these in the game, in the box. So it would have been nice perhaps to have two, one for each player. So you can kind of be looking at your next move and planning your attack while the other chaps are banging away at you. Now this information here, you've got your AP fire, your defensive capability, your movement rate, and then the HE capability as well. And depending on the color, it's going to determine which range you can fire out to, right? And all that sort of good stuff. And there's the definitions of long and short range here. And infantry is going to have close assault capabilities and things like that. So a really nice use of color and numerals to help you understand what your unit capabilities are and kind of go for it from there. All right, so very straightforward from that perspective. And I think as you saw with the counters, very pretty, very clean. Let's try and get to the... There's all over here. I've got the German counters here, but you can see that they... They're nice and easy to read. The little watermarks in the background, not too obtrusive. I think they look quite okay. Very nice, very nice. So, got little Stukas here, little air units. So that's the main game. So you're picking up four counter sheets, a lot of units by the looks of it, and a dozen scenarios. Let me put this over here. Let me just see if there was indeed a third one of those. Did I see one? No, I did. Okay. All right, we're hitting 12 minutes here and I haven't got to the rest of it. So, there are some custom dice. There is a cool little mouse mat, which I'm going to adopt right now and use on my PC. A little surface that's a... cute little thing. And let's have a look at this next expansion, which also has pretty groovy art. Come on, fellas. All right. It's going to make me get tough. Okay. So more scenarios. If I can get it out. So we've got box expansion, a new sheet of counters, which will include Jag Tigers, King Tigers, Panthers, T-34-85s, IS-3s, another map, and a whole bunch of scenarios. Scenario one, first contact. Breakout, so 2, 6 scenarios in that. So that's a nice whack of extra scenarios. Another set of nice counters. More groovy dudes. You can see your King Tigers there for all the German files and T-34-85s. The Stalin. And another map, which is also... sure able to be connected. This is quite a heavily wooded map as well, so that is pretty interesting. So that's going to give you a lot of replay value, and significant ability to build out some pretty cool scenarios either yourself or just play as you desire with your buddies. So very nice package of goodies, and it looks like the rules are eminently consumable, clocking in at 8 to 10 pages. I will be looking to see if I can get this on the table in the next week or so. I've got their other new game that came out, the OST Ghost Front title set up and waiting for me to start rolling dice. So I also have an extra copy of the Ghost Front title. So if you happen to watch this video all the way to the end and post a comment in this video, on this video on YouTube, you will go into the running for a draw in the next week or so to win a copy of the expansion, the Ghost Front expansion. You're going to need to be an original owner of the West Front OST to take advantage of it, but nevertheless, it's a very nice expansion, and you will have a chance to go in a draw to win that. Talk to you soon. Tell a friend or something. Ciao.